الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على محمد رسول الله سيد الأولين والآخرين وإمام الأنبياء والمرسلين والشافع المشفع يوم الدين وعلى آله الطيبين وأزواجه الطاهرات أمهات المؤمنين وصحابته الغر الميامين ومن استنى بسنته واهتدى بهديه إلى يوم الدين أما بعده حياكم الله my dear brothers and sisters to this talk today which was supposed to be about the explanation of الأصول الثلاثة but since we are today on the 12th of Rabi al-Awwal we want to ask this question and answer it and answer it as well what is so special about 12th of Rabi al-Awwal? Some people say it is the day in which Rasulullah was born. But there is no any authentic narration to confirm that. As in the books of history, such as Al-Bidayah wal-Nihaya, Tariq for Imam al-Bukhari, Tariq for many other ulama who wrote about the history of Islam and the biography of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they all say that there is no any confirmation that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. Some said on the 1st of Rabi' al-Awwal, some said 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal, some said in other months. There are many different opinions. And that shows and proves that there is nothing authentic about that. What was authentic about 12th Rabi' al-Awwal is the death of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He died on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal, no doubt. With the agreement of all the ulama that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. Now what is confirmed about his birth is what he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. He used to fast every Monday and he was asked about this, why you are fasting every Monday? He said, Monday is the day in which I was born and I like to fast on it. Now, this is not a legislation for anyone to fast the day on in which he was born. La, that is only for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Why? Because none of us, no human's birth was so. Beneficial and virtue for all the nations, for all the creation, but Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As Allah Ta'ala said, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا وَخَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Allah Ta'ala said, say, O Muhammad, by the virtue of Allah, blessings of Allah, and the mercy of Allah, let them then be happy with. That is better than all that what they collect and gather and say, meaning of wealth. What the ulama said about this ayah, they said the virtue of Allah, the blessing of Allah is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the mercy is the Quran, and some said the virtue is the Quran, and the mercy is Muhammad, and all are right, and all are mentioned in the Quran. Allah Ta'ala said, وَأَرْسَلْنَاكَ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We send you not but as a mercy for all creation. So from there we understand that fasting on the day of birth is only for Rasulullah. And that is not a celebration. That is not a celebration, ikhwah. So some people say, see, he was celebrating every Monday because he was born on Monday. We say, first of all, if you want to fast every Monday, as he used to fast every Monday, with the intention that he was born on Monday, that is good. because you are following him now in the action and in the intention. But if you want to do something, and this is not a celebration. Fasting is not a celebration. That's why the Eid al-Fitr is a celebration. Eid al-Adha is a celebration, and both Eid we are not allowed to fast on. We are not allowed to fast on. Whatsoever, we are not allowed to fast. Why? Because it's a day of celebration. You don't fast. You don't fast. So we are fasting as a worship, as a thankfulness. Exactly like when the Prophet ﷺ came to Medina and found the Yahud fasting on Ashura, he asked, what day is this? They said, it's a day in which Allah survived Musa and those who believed with him. And he, John, he made Fir'aun and those who disbelieved along with him to drown in the sea. And so Musa fasted this day as a way of thankfulness to Allah, and we fasted. The Prophet ﷺ said, we have more right than you with Musa. Then he fasted and he commanded the Sahaba to fast. So from all that we know that fasting is not a celebration. Fasting is a way of thankfulness. And as Allah Ta'ala said, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you may have piety and become righteous and become pious. That is why we fast, whether Ramadan, 6 days of Shawwal, first 10 days or 9 days of the Hijjah, Ashura, Arafah, 3 days in the middle of the month, Mondays and Thursdays, most of Sha'ban, most of Muharram. These all days we fast. Why? To show us, to show Allah Ta'ala the thankfulness of us. Now, so from there we say, the Prophet Sallallahu no confirmation that he was born on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. The confirmation is that he died on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. It is confirmed that it is reported authentically that he was born on Monday, and it is reported authentically that he used to fast Monday as a way of thankfulness to Allah the Almighty, that he created this most noble and humble human to the whole creation as a mercy from Allah the Almighty. That's why he used to fast. The Sahaba used to fast Mondays, and all the believers love to fast Mondays, whether they fast or they don't fast, but they love to fast Mondays because it's a sunnah of Rasulullah. That's why we say, if you love Rasulullah, then follow him. Allah Ta'ala said in the Quran, Ya Ikhwa, Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Ali Imran, Ayah 31, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Say, O Muhammad, to them all, if you people say that you do love Allah and you are sincere with Allah in worship, then follow me. Follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How? Follow him in everything. Let me give you some examples, the echo of those. First of all, let us come to an agreement to what is the sunnah and what is the bid'ah. Right? Let's have an agreement to the definition of sunnah and bid'ah. And before that, as a precedent to that, is to see the manhaj, the way that Allah drawn for us in the Quran, showed us in the Quran. Allah Ta'ala said to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to say to the people of scripture, the Yahud and the Nasara, قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ, say, O people of the scripture, تَعَالَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَىٰ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ, come to a midst wall between you and us. أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, that we worship not but Allah. وَلَا يَتَّخِذْ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ, and that none of us take the other as lords or gods besides Allah. So Allah Ta'ala showed the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam the manhaj. You are sent to call to Tawheed. Show them what is Tawheed. Tawheed because the Jews claim that they are the believers. The Christians believe they claim that they are the believers. Allah said, okay, we all together, people with the revelation, let's come to way or word, and that we all worship not but Allah. Stop worshiping any others. Okay, so this is Tawheed. Now, what is the Sunnah? What is the Sunnah? The Sunnah is what Allah Ta'ala said in Ayah 31 of Surah Ali Imran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. So, فَاتَّبِعُونِي. That is the Sunnah. The Sunnah is the way of how to go to Allah. It is how to please Allah. That is the Sunnah. No one can tell you how to please Allah except Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Simply because he is the only one that his speech is not out of his mind. His speech of religion, I mean, is not out of his mind. But it is revelation, as Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Najm. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ. He never utters out of desire. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. But he is a revelation revealed to him. All what he says to you about the religion, about how to please Allah, how to come to Allah, how to reach the Jannah, that is all revelation. See, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us how to pray, was that out of his mind? La, it was revelation. Was revelation. When he taught us how to perform Hajj, this is from Allah by the revelation, like that. So, whatever a way or a method that you seek to please Allah with must be according to the revelation, must adhere the revelation from Allah. If it does not adhere it, then it's not going to take you to Allah. Impossible, totally impossible. So my brothers and sisters, whatever deed you worship Allah with, it must come through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Must come through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If it is not through him, then throw it away. If it is not through him, then throw it away. It's not going to benefit you. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, عليكم بسنتي. Hold on, grasp on, take my sunnah. وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي. And the sunnah of those guided خلفاء after me. Who these are? Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali. See what you do. Have they done it? Yes, take it. No, avoid it. Period. How simple it is? Very simple. You say, oh, you guys don't want us to love Rasul. No, love him. Love him and prove your love by what Allah Ta'ala said. Follow him. Follow him. That is the proof. That is the proof. Follow him in your belief. Don't say, I love Rasulullah, and then you go to the deceased body in the grave and ask him, oh, Wali, Rasulullah. That's not a following of Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You love him, then follow him. Pray as he prayed. Don't make a new way of praying. Do dhikr as he taught you how to do dhikr. Don't innovate. Don't mix. I tell you something. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught Fatima and Ali what to say so they get the strength through the day. He said, when you go to your bed, then say Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. That is not the same way of after Salah. La, 34 times of Allahu Akbar, that's it, that's 100. He said, this is better for you than a servant to serve you during the day. Right, that is one way. That is to say it when? When you are on bed about to sleep. Aisha radiallahu anha said that he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he used to go to bed, he used to gather his hands and blew air in it and recite al-ikhlas and qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq, qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas, and then wipe over his head and whatever he can reach of his body. And he repeats that three times. When and where? When he is going to sleep, on bed. He does that. He does that. Now you see people after Salah, what they do? They do the tasbih, but 33 and 1 to complete the 100, la ilaha illallah. That is according to the teachings of Rasulullah. What is that according to it? They got the hadith of Fatima, tasbih, and they got the hadith of Aisha, blowing and reciting, and they brought it here after Salah. They open here and they pull it, the blue air here, and then they wipe. You see them even in the masjid. Where you got this from? This combination of ahadith, where you got it from? Did Abu Bakr do it? Did Umar do it? Did Ali? Did Uthman do it? Did Ali do it? Did any of the Sahaba do it? Did Fatima? Did Aisha? Did Hassan? Did Hussein? Did Abbas? Did Abdullah ibn Abbas? Did Abu Hanifa do it? Did Malik ibn Anas do it? Did Ahmed ibn Hanbal do it? Did Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i do it? Did al-Bukhari do it? Did Muslim do it? Did Abu Dawud do it? Did al-Nasa'i do it? Did any alim do it? Subhanallah. How come you know more than these all? Ya akhi, forget about them all. How come you know more than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Didn't you hear him saying, من عمل عملا ليس عليه أمرنا فهو رد. Didn't you hear that in Sahih Muslim? On the authority of Aisha radiallahu anha, he whoever does any act of worship which is not from our way, which we did not do, then it is rejected. Akhi, yani, wake up. Don't come on the day of election. Ya ikhwan, innovation is so dangerous. Innovation is so dangerous. Someone may now jump up and say, where is the innovation? Is this innovation? We love Rasulullah. We do something that, ya akhi. What is the definition of innovation? And Imam al-Shatibi in his book al-Ihtisam said, هي طريقة في الدين مخترع. It is a way innovated in the religion. Meaning it wasn't there before that. At the time of Rasulullah, it was not there. تضاعي الشرعية, it equals the legislated way of worship. طيب, but the legislated way is from the way of Rasulullah. This one is not from the way of Rasulullah. Some who brought it. طيب, يراد بها التقرب إلى الله. The one who invented it, innovated it, found it, and those who do it following him on it, why do they do that? They seek nearness with Allah through it. Exactly like how they seek nearness by salah, by siyam, by sadaqah, by hajj, by umrah, by tawaf, by dhikr. They also seek nearness with Allah by this. Fine. If you are seeking nearness by Allah to Allah by this, then how come this thing Rasulullah did not know, did not do, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Ibn Abbas, whoever, Abbas, the Prophet's uncle, didn't do it. Ya akhi, wake up. Don't sell your mind to the others for nothing. Wake up. Why I say that? Because anybody insists to continue on the innovation and does not repent, then he must know that Allah has prevented the acceptance of his repentance from any sin until he stopped the innovation. That is the first punishment. Second is on the day of resurrection. You know, on the day of resurrection, that day of resurrection is 50,000 years long. 50,000 years long. No one will sit. Everyone is standing. 50,000 years standing. Bare feet. Naked. Uncircumcised. Right? And the sun is only 1 mile away from your head. Guess how much sweat you are going to make. How much moisture you are going to lose of your body. how much thirst you are going to severe of. Huh? So, on that day, you need to drink. Today, I'm talking to you, I just opened the bottle and drank. And now, wallahi, I'm in need to drink. Although I'm sitting in a room where air conditioning is running and temperature here in Jeddah is nearly 32 or 30. But every other minute I'm thirsty. It is night, not day, so the sun is near. And the sun is 150 million so-and-so, they say, so far from the earth. And I'm thirsty. Guess what? On the day of resurrection. Fear Allah. Fear Allah about yourself. Rescue yourself, ya akhi. Wake up. Let me shake you. Say, wake up. You are putting yourself in a serious trouble. So, that day is a long day. People will need to drink. They all will go to the lake of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But some people are not going to be allowed in. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, يُدَادُ رِجَالٌ مِّنْ أُمَّةِ عَنْ حَوْضِ. Some men are going to be pushed away. Men meaning men or women, whoever innovate. Pushed away from my lake. And then he said, I will say, my ummah, and then he will be responded saying, you don't know what they have invaded after you. What he said then, he says, suhqan, suhqan, destroy them. Why? Because Allah revealed to him on the day of Arafah, on the 10th year of Hijrah, just 2 months and couple of days before he died, he revealed to him, Al-Yawma Akmaltu Lakum Deena. Today I completed the religion for you. Those who bring something that Rasulullah did not bring, and he did not do, and the Sahaba did not do, those people are saying to Allah, no. You did not complete the religion on the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, on the 10th year of Hijrah. You did not. Allah said, I did. They say, no, you did not. Subhanallah. And they want to bring something new to Islam. That is, ya ikhwan, dangerous. Very dangerous. Be careful. Stay on the rock of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah has sealed all ways that people may think it lead to Jannah and made only one straight path, that is the path of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the Jannah. If you don't follow him, you never reach Jannah. You never reach Jannah. Be careful, therefore. Be careful. Don't say that is, I'm muwahid, but this is a small innovation. La. As Imam Ahmad said about the ayah where Allah Ta'ala said, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَارِبُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةً وَيُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Imam Ahmad said the fitna in this ayah is shirk. He will start leaving, committing bid'ah after bid'ah, then leaving sunnah after sunnah until he commit the shirk, come out of tawheed. So be careful. Don't listen to anybody, ya ikhwan. Anybody talk to you, say, bring me the proof from the Quran and the Sunnah. Did the Sahaba do it? How did they understand it? That is the way. That is the way. وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. As in Surah Al-Imran, Allah Ta'ala said, and he, whoever opposed the Messenger of Allah, and takes away other than the way of the believers, then we'll let him go with what he chooses. But we will put him in the severe punishment of Jahannam. So, my brothers and sisters, be careful. Stay away from all innovation. Wallahi, ya ikhwah, if the Muslim does not do more than the obligatory worships, does not pray except 5 times a day. Even the sunnah before and after, he doesn't do it. Does not fast but Ramadan. Even 6 days of Shawwal, he does not do it. Does not give out charity, but the zakah, obligatory zakah. Even if he does not do hajj except once in his lifetime, and dies with that, without innovation, wallahi, he will drink from the lake of Rasulullah and he will end up in Jannah. But you come up with many huge deeds, but they all not up on the way of Rasulullah. قَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. We will come to all the work that they have done, meaning the worships, and we will throw it as a flying dust. Finish. It doesn't benefit you. It doesn't benefit you to innovate in the deen. Why? Why? Why you innovate? Why you make bid'ah in the deen? So be careful, my brothers and sisters. Don't listen to those who say, oh, we do the maulid because we love Rasulullah. Say to them, you love him and Abu Bakr didn't. You love him and Umar didn't. You love him and Uthman didn't. You love him and Ali didn't. You love him and Al-Abbas, his uncle, didn't. You love him and Fatima didn't. You love him and Aisha didn't. What do you say? What do you talk about? Wake up. You guys are fooling yourself and fooling your followers. And you are throwing them into the hellfire, jumping over them later on. As Allah Ta'ala said, قَالَتْ أُولَاهُمْ لِأُخْرَاهُمْ. So be careful, my brothers and sisters. Be careful of the bid'ah. Two things, shirk and bid'ah, if you avoid, I guarantee you the Jannah. As Allah Ta'ala said, as Allah Ta'ala said, Allah said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Indeed, Allah forgives not all any association for anybody who associated with Him and worship. But Allah forgives all that which all that sin, which is below shirk, below association. Right. This is one ayah. The other ayah, Allah Ta'ala said what? In Surah Al-Imran, Allah Ta'ala said what? وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصَّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. He whoever obeys Allah and the Messenger, then he is going to be with the Prophet, the believers, the martyrs, and the good doers. So, my brothers and sisters, conclusion of the advice of today is do not just blindly imitate. La, Allah deferred you from all other creation by this. Think, look, hear, talk, ask questions. You have to use your senses. You have a tongue that must ask, where's the proof? Where's the delil? Did the Prophet ﷺ do it? Did the Sahaba do it? You have ear to, when you ask them, hear from them. If what you hear adheres the authentic sunnah, take it, alhamdulillah. If it does not adhere the authentic sunnah, then leave it. Use your sighting sense to look in the ya akhi, the books of sunnah there. Yani Allah created for this ummah men who Allah did not create like them in the previous nations. Where in the previous nations a man like Bukhari? Where in the previous nations a man like a Muslim, like al-Nasai, Ibn Majah, Abu Dawood, al-Tirmidhi, al-Darqutni, al-Bayhaqi, Yahya ibn Ma'in, many. What's the duty of these people? These people were only reservoirs of knowledge. They are reservoirs of knowledge. They accumulate knowledge. Allah gave them so much knowledge of what? Of hadith, memorization. They memorized the hadith with the narrations and they analyzed them, which narrator is strong in memory, which one is weak, which one is honest, which one is liar, which one is doubtful, which was like that. They segregated Imam al-Bukhari worked hard to bring us this book, As-Sahih. Sahih al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim the same. So we have to fear Allah and yani take proper responsibility of our religion. Here we end up today. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.